So hello students, today you have multiple choice question discussion on animal kingdom part 2, which includes chordates. First question, see, animals of class mammalia have what type of features? Typical features they are asking. 7 cervical vertebrae. Next is 7 cranial nerves will be wrong. We have 12 cranial nerves. Single ventricular chamber is wrong. And 4 cervical vertebrae also will be wrong. So correct answer is majority or almost all the mammals will have 7 cervical vertebrae. But however, in certain aquatic mammals, there also 7 vertebrae will be there, but they will have got fused. So next one is, which one of the following matches is incorrect? Which of the following matches is incorrect? Here, what is there? Garden lizard is called, actually, it is given in NCERT practical book. It is called Calotus. But here they have given Hemidactylus. Therefore, first one is incorrect. Correct answer is first option. Whereas mountain lizard is called Varanus is correct. But they are asking what is incorrect, remember. So this will not be answered. Worm lizard is right. This also is correct, but they are asking incorrect. So remaining 3 will not be correct. The next question. Which of the following pairs of animals comprises of jawless fish? Eels are not jawless, but lamprey is jawless. But two of both together should be jawless. So first one is not an answer. Mackerel and rogue, both are not the answer. Lamprey and hagfish is the correct answer. So answer is third one. Lamprey and hagfish, also called myxin. Lamprey are called petromyxon. They belong to cyclostomes, which are jawless fish. Remember, jawless fish don't have true fins and they don't have scales. Okay, so therefore they cannot be considered or compared to fish. Guppies, these are fish, and this only one. So only where both are the jawless fish is the third option. Cerebral hemisphere of rat is connected by, say, rat is a mammal. And rat belong to eutherian. And eutherians a special feature. All the eutherians, these are the group of mammals. Their special feature is connection between the right hemisphere of the brain with that of left hemisphere. And that is called corpus callosum. It is a connection between a right hemisphere as well as left. Nervous connection, nervous tissue connection will be there between the right hemisphere and left. That is only present in mammals, and that to eutherians. It is not present even in metatherians like post animals, neither it is present in protherians like that of duck-billed platypus. It is not present in them. So it is not present in duck-billed platypus, it is not present in post animals, but it is present in placental mammals called eutherians. So eutherians is also, it is eutherians, EU, eutherians are also called placental mammals. Correct answer is second one. Whereas corpus albicans, luteum, and spongiosum, these are reproductive parts, and some are relevant to system. Most of them are relevant to reproductive system. Age of fish. Now, among the in the geological time scale, which was the era of fish? It was Devonian period, it should be actually. Okay, Devonian period of Paleozoic era. Devonian period of Paleozoic era. Whereas Ordovician, Silurian, Permian, here fish did not dominate the earth. So correct answer, fish dominated on the earth in the Devonian period. Which of the following vertebrates show formation of middle ear for the first time? You know that how is the evolution occurring? Evolution occurs, Pisces are supposed to be evolving in amphibians. Amphibians evolved into what? Reptiles. Then there was a bifurcation. Some of them formed birds, and these reptiles are also ancestors for mammals. But this is how the evolution took place. Now they're asking for a first time, when did the middle ear come? That means the fish don't have middle ear. Okay, first time middle ear came in amphibians. Now among the four options, the amphibian will be which one? Rana tigrina, that is the second frog, which is an amphibian. Which of the following statement is true? This is a repetition, but you should know it as a good practice. It will be a good practice. All chordates or vertebrates will be wrong. There are some chordates which are not vertebrates. It can be jawless fish, it can be urochordates, it can be cephalochordates. Then all, okay, jawless fish belong to vertebrates. Jawless fish belong to vertebrates. Which do not belong to vertebrates is urochordata and cephalochordata. All vertebrates are chordate. This is true. The second one is true. Invertebrates possesses tubular nerve, but they possess solid nerve. Non-chordates have vertebral column. They do not have vertebral column. Then only they are called as non-chordates or invertebrates. Which of the following is an exclusive character of mammalia? Exclusive means key characters present in all of the mammals. Okay. Homeothermy. Okay. Then there is internal fertilization, presence of four chambers. Now you can see all mammals compulsorily have muscular diaphragm. So correct answer is fourth one. Plus all mammals should compulsorily have glands, mammary glands. So these two are without exception the characteristic features of mammals. There are some mammals that undergo hibernation like that of undergo state of dormancy also. So here fourth one, presence of muscular diaphragm. Chondrite thighs are nothing but cartilage fish whose endoskeleton is cartilage. Then among the four options, what do they have? What scales they are made up of, or what is it? They have a ventral mouth is correct, but which is the scales present in chondrite thighs? The scales present in chondrite thighs are called placoid scales. Okay, these are typical. Then whereas you see ctenoid, Okay, one minute. Students, 1 minute. There is also ventral mouth and placoid scale. There is an option here. Placoid scale and ventral mouth. So correct answer will be fourth one and not the first one. Placoid scale as well as ventral mouth, which is given in option four. Ctenoid scales, they resemble like comb. They are present in bony fish, that is ostrich thighs. Ampulla of Lorenzini. It is a sensory structure. It is present in the snout region. It is supposed to be present in fish. And for example, it is present in shark. and sharp near the snout region, that is in front, okay, anterior most part, near the snout region, this ampulla of Lorenzini will be there. This ampulla of Lorenzini can sense the temperature of water. It is useful for sensing temperature of water. Okay, so it is a thermosensitive part of fish. So however, this structure is not present in lizard, frog or rabbit. It is supposed to be present in fish. Okay, and that too, best example is that of shark. The character that differentiates chordates from non-chordates. How does chordate be different from non? Triploblastic body. However, this is not a difference. Both have three germinal layers. Heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Both have heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Dorsal hollow nerve cord. This is the correct answer. You should know that the nerve cord of chordates is hollow, whereas the nerve cord of non-chordates or invertebrates is solid, and here it is hollow. So sexual reproduction can occur. So common is, these three are common between them. They occur in both of the groups, but which will occur only in one group is dorsal tibular nerve cord. That itself differentiates a chordate from non-chordate. Which of the following reptiles have four-chambered heart? Crocodile have four-chambered heart. Understand? Whereas lizard, snake, scorpion, however, this is an invertebrate. The remaining will be having three-chambered heart. Remember, reptiles are made up of, most of the reptiles are made up of three-chambered heart. It means that there are two auricles and one ventricle. And you should know that the ventricle has wall, partial interventricular valve is there. Partial interventricular wall is there. That means the single ventricle has a wall, that too not completely dividing the ventricle, but a partially dividing wall is there in that ventricle. It means that suppose if this is the two auricle and one ventricle, there is no complete separation of ventricle, only partial separation is there. It means that the blood can get mixed, oxygenated and deoxygenated blood can get mixed in the ventricle. But crocodile have one of the mammalian characters, or you can tell even higher animal characters like mammals, that is four-chambered heart. There is a complete separation between the two ventricles. When there is a complete interventricular wall is there, means how many ventricles will form? Two separate ventricles will form. So the crocodile has two atrium and two ventricles. A gradual decrease in the size of tail during metamorphosis. So when the metamorphosis word is used, I always told you all, it is the word used for larva. When a larva forms adult, that itself is called metamorphosis. Understand? Now when the larva, you see, for example, larva of the frog they have given. In that, tadpole will have a tail. What is the purpose of that tail? It will help in movement. Now that tail will be there in larva, and this tail will disappear in adult. How is that? You know that if anything grows, if there is a growth, means we say that basis is cell division. Now if there is a disappearance of a tail, means what is the basis of it? The basis will be cell death. Understand? Cell necrosis, no. Tissue necrosis word can be used here. Cell senescence, no. Because in the aging cell is called cell senescence here. The source is not. Outcome is what? Pinocytic activity also not. Correct answer is programmed cell death. Programmed cell death is also called apoptosis. So due to cell death, what happens? The cells present in the tail will undergo programmed cell death. It means they will die. When the cell dies, this is gradually when many of the cells in the tail region die, the tail is going to disappear. That is one of the changes occurring during metamorphosis of tadpole to adult. And tadpole is the larva of frog. So branch of zoology dealing with fish. Here will be ichthyology. It is the study of fish. Herpetology. Herpetology is both the study of reptiles as well as amphibians. Okay. Both study of reptiles as well as amphibians. Mammalogy will be study of mammals. Ornithology will be study of birds. All mammals without any exception, there should be no exception at all. Which is that correct? I have already told in the previous. The correct answer, viviparity. So they are egg-laying mammals also, like duck-billed platypus. So this will not, there is an exception here. If there is an exception, this is not an answer. Extra abdominal testis. I told extra abdominal testis. There is one animal, mammal, that has intra abdominal testis, and that is elephant and seal. So this heterodontid. There are some mammals who don't have teeth, unlike anteater. So this will not be an answer. But every mammal should have what? Muscular diaphragm and milk producing glands called mammary glands. The correct answer is both. Next one, options will show up. So you can read the sentence here. Torpedo. The electric ray is called, it has electrical organs that are capable of generating strong electric shock to paralyze the prey. That is correct. They are capable of producing electricity. Okay. Bony fish use pectoral, pelvic, dorsal, anal, caudal fins to swim. Yes. In one or the other way, these fins will help in swimming. Amphibian skin is moist, as scales is wrong. Because of this, scales, this sentence is wrong. Birds are poikilothermic. No, they are homeothermic. So they neither hibernate or estivate. This also is wrong. Most unique mammalian characteristic is presence of milk-producing mammary glands by which the young ones are nourished. This also is correct. This is the uniquest feature. Okay. So among the option, they are telling we have to separate which is true and then write separately which is false. So which was true here? 1, 2 and 5 is correct. So you have to see 1, 2 and 5 is true. Whereas 3rd and 4th is false. Correct answer is 2nd one. Excretory material of bony fish. That is the difference between bony fishes. Bony fish will excrete ammonia. But cartilage fish will excrete urea. So that is the difference. So correct answer, excretory material, you know, they are the nitrogenous waste material. They are usually as the outcome of protein metabolism. So terrestrial animals will excrete urea and chondrocytes will excrete urea, protein, and certain animals will excrete amino acid. But here they are not asking those. They are asking only bony fish will excrete what? They will excrete. Okay, next. Jacobson organ. It is olfactory organ where there is a sense of smell. In which animal is Jacobson's organ present? Okay. Jacobson's organ is noticed. A similar kind of structure is present in rat, snake as well as man, but it is more distinct in the snakes. Okay. So this is supposed to be present in the warmer bone. Okay. It is also supposed to be in rat and even in man. So what is the function? It is olfactory function. It is very distinct in snake. In snake, it is supposed to be present near the warmer bone at the junction of the nasal cavity as well as mouth. But the organs, the Jacobson organ, similar kind of structure is also present in human and rats. Each thiophase belongs to class. Each thiophase is limbless amphibians. Limbless amphibian is called as its thiophase. So correct answer is third one. Next. See, which of the following is a catadromous fish? Catadromous will migrate from fresh water to sea, and anadromous will migrate from sea to fresh water for spawning. And they return, once they develop, they return back. Okay. So eel, freshwater eel Angula is the, and whereas these all are freshwater fish. So this is the marine fish. Hilsa is the marine fish. But for this question, these three are not the answer. Okay, so Angula is eel. Then we have catadromous. So pancreas is absent in cyclostomes. Pancreas is absent in cyclostomes, but it is present. So jawless fish. So pancreas is absent in jawless fish. Lateral line sense organ. That means you can know from anterior to the posterior of the fish, a line runs at the center. Okay. So those, that is called as lateral line sense organ. Now where it is occurring, here you see which is the fish here, scoloidon is a fish. And lateral line sense organ not only occurs in fish, it will occur in all of the aquatic vertebrates. Now, what is the function of lateral line sense organ? They have some receptors, they are called as rheoreceptors. With the help of these receptors, they are able to detect water currents. For example, if there is an object, or if there is any small animal moving nearby, so there is a local change in the water current, and that can be sensed in the, by this lateral line sense organ. So if I say aquatic vertebrate like cyclostomes, they will also have similar lateral lines. Fish will have lateral line sense organs. So therefore, scoloidon is an aquatic one. It is a chondrich thighs. Even ostrich thighs will have. Even jawless fish will have. So it is basically present in all of the aquatic vertebrates. WVC of frog are nucleated and amoeboid. Whereas RBCs are, RBC of amphibians and frog is biconvex and nucleated. WBCs are amoeboid cells. They are not concave or they are non-nucleated. No, they are nucleated. So correct answer is first one. First one is the correct answer. And also you should know that RBCs in amphibians and in reptiles and birds, they will be biconvex and nucleated. And in mammal, the camel and llama will have biconvex nucleated RBC. Otherwise, in mammals, remaining all will have biconcave annucleated, means without nucleus, the RBC will be present. So they are asking here, not RBC, but WBC. So they are amoeboid cells. Limbless amphibians is its thiophil. So these all are the Indian bull frog like that. These are salamanders. These all are amphibians only. In that they are asking limbless amphibian, the one does not have limb is ichthyophis. Now what is the speciality of ichthyophis is? Amphibians actually don't have scales, but ichthyophis have scales, but under the skin. Under the skin. So they are asked, they have given a description about kangaroo rat. They have dark in color will not be correct. Okay. They secrete solid urine will be correct. High rate of reproduction is of no use for adaptation. So first one is wrong. They do not drink water is correct. They breathe very slowly again, conserve water. Body is covered by hair. It's not typically like thick hair. So this also totally it won't be correct. They feed on dry seeds is correct. They do not require water for drinking. Even this is supposed to be correct. You see, they excrete concentrated urine. That is correct. How many times it's concentration? 20 times then plasma. 3 times then plasma. So whatever plasma concentration is there, 20 times it will be more concentrated. In case of humans, it will be 4 times more concentrated. But in it will be 20 times more concentrated. Now, do not use water to regulate body temperature. So it will produce water by metabolism of carbohydrates, fats, and proteins. And that water it will save. Okay, that metabolic water only it will conserve. But body temperature, there is no need to regulate because it will already live in burrows. Okay, so this answer which will be correct is third and fourth. Okay, the first one will be. Which of the following features are present in chordates? So chordate feature. So here they're asking, they're expecting you to know about diagnostic features of chordates. Diagnostic features you should know. What are the diagnostic features? Diagnostic features are presence of notochord. And second diagnostic feature is postanal tail. Third will be like pharyngeal gill slits and notochord and dorsal hollow nerve cord. These are the diagnostic. But among this, which is given as a list, dorsal heart will be wrong. It's present. Mental heart will be correct. Presence of postanal tail becker, presence of nasal. This will be correct. So correct answer is second one. Now again, dorsal heart is there, so cancel it out first step itself. So mental heart correct. Absence of notochord will again be incorrect. So correct answer. So choosing the correct one will be the second one. So you should keep it in mind. The features that are present in any stage of the chordates, either in the embryonic stage or in the adult stage, these characters should be present. That is, mental heart, dorsal hollow nerve cord, notochord, and pharyngeal gill slits and postanal tail. Postanal tail is present where? It is just one of the diagnostic characters. Postanal tail, that is tail, is present. Even though human beings don't have tail, but embryonic stages have tail. In at least any stages of the life cycle, these characters should be present. So now postanal tail is present in chordates. Vertebrates also, yes. Invertebrates, no. Answer will be what? Both 1 and answer will be both 1 and 2 because postanal tail is a character of chordate and vertebrate is nothing but a chordate. So answer will be both 1 and 2. Change, what is the phenomena by which larva is converted into adult? What is that phenomena called? I have been always telling it is nothing but metamorphosis. The word metamorphosis should be applied only to larva. You cannot use in embryonic development or fetal development. Now you see, changes that allow conversion of larva to adult is called metamorphosis. Metagenesis means what? Alteration of generation occurring in typically where cylindrates. Alternation is just the term used here, so it will be wrong. Metastasis is advanced stages where the tumor starts spreading in the body. It is related to cancer. So correct answer will be third. Now, which sound producing organ is present in birds? Bird sound producing organ is called syrinx, whereas in mammals it is called larynx. Trachea is called windpipe. And pharynx is common passage both for food and air. Now what you should know is, in human beings, for example, human beings, larynx is called as a sound box. So this is just a portion of sound box. Then sound box will continue as trachea. Okay, this is windpipe. So this is the sound box. Now what you will see here in mammals, first what will come? Sound box will come. Then what will come? Trachea will come, which is windpipe. But in birds, it is opposite. In majority of the birds, first will come what? Trachea. Then comes what? A sound box. Then there is a bronchus. So in birds, trachea comes first, then sound box comes afterwards. Then sound box in mammals is called larynx, and sound box in birds is called syrinx. Which of the following is not a mammalian character? Presence of milk producing organ is a mammalian character. They have two pairs of limbs is also a mammalian character. Skin has possess hair is also a mammalian character. Now correct answer is homodont teeth. Mammals are what? They are heterodont. And they are what? They are heterodont, and then what they will be? Thecodont. Got thecodont and heterodont. Homodont means the shape, the size, okay, of teeth will be same. So you can see that mammals' teeth won't be the same. They are different in that. Incisors, canines, premolars, molars. Why they call? Because they differ in the shape and size and even functioning also. Homodont teeth means they are similar in shape and size. That kind will be present in lower animals, but not mammals. In birds, at least teeth won't be there, but in reptiles and amphibians, it will be homodont. But however, crocodile is thecodont. Okay, crocodile is heterodont. Pouched mammals. Now, pouched mammals are called marsupials. Pouched mammals are called as marsupials. Now, prototherians means egg-laying mammals, like a duck-billed platypus. Duck-billed platypus is a connecting link between reptiles and mammals. Okay, that is evolution. Metatherians are pouched mammals. Correct it is. Pouched. So, this is wrong. This will be correct. Now, marsupial also is correct. Marsupial is nothing but pouched mammals. So, correct answer is 2 and 3. Correct answer will be 2 and 3. So, you should know that mammals are divided into prototherians, metatherians, and eutherians. Prototherians are egg-laying mammals, metatherians are pouched mammals, and eutherians are placental mammals. So, taxonomical classification of frog, they're asking, how do you classify the frog till genus level, starting from phylum, then what is that? Class, order, family, genus, this type of classification will be there. So, which will be correct with respect to frog? Frog is a chordate, so here it will be correct. Then it is a vertebrate. Vertebrate are called craniata. So, these two will be wrong. Either this. Then within the vertebrate, it is jawed, so gnathostomata. But directly you cannot take vertebrate here. So, correct answer will be second. So, chordata, craniata, gnathostomata, and then what is that? Amphibia. In amphibia, it belongs to genus Rana, and species is Rana tigrina. So, craniata is nothing but vertebrata. The vertebrate special character is what? Vertebral column plus there is presence of cranium. So, chordata, craniata, in crania, gnatha and gnathostomata. It is jawed, so it is gnathostomata. This will be the correct answer. The second one will be the correct answer. Then which of the following is, you should put a space here, Caecilian. Now Caecilian is ichthyophis, is also called Caecilians. What are Caecilians? Limbless amphibians. Limbless amphibians. Nimbus amphibians are called caesareans. Okay, so remaining are not relevant to caesareans. Okay. In which animal diaphragm has no role in respiration? Rat is all mammals, these all are. So they have a role in respiration. Diaphragm has a very key role in respiration, both inspiration as well as expiration. But frog don't have diaphragm. It does not have diaphragm. Frog do not have any diaphragm. So therefore, it has a no role in breathing at all. So which of the following is correctly matched? Okay, directly I will tell. You should know that. Well, I got to is actually the catfish. Whereas these all are freshwater fishes. Freshwater fish. So correctly matched is tengra, katla, pies is a freshwater fish, but they are not called so. Only the first one is correct. Well, I go up to the catfish. Proboscis gland is present in balanoglossus. Balanoglossus is hemichordata. Hemichordata associated with what? Excretion. Because which gland is present in proboscis gland? Means it is present in the proboscis of the hemichordates. Okay, hornworm or tongue worm, they say. Their proboscis consists of a proboscis gland, and proboscis gland's responsibility is excretion. Correct sequence, it should be correct sequence in embryonic development. Frog also will have, in early embryonic stages, frog also will have the same stages just like human beings, you should know that. So first what is formed? Zygote is formed. Zygote will undergo special type of division called cleavage. After cleavage, blastula is formed and then gastrula is formed. So correct answer is first one. Frog is called as blastula, but for mammals, the blastula is called as blastocyst. The group do not have, which of this group do not have extra embryonic membrane? And they are given the name of the extra membrane is, say, for example, it does not have amnion. So those eggs that do not have amnion are called anamnioates. Okay. Anamnioates means includes the one that do not have cleidoic egg. So fish and amphibians is the correct answer. Whereas reptiles, birds are all called amnioates. Reptiles, birds, mammals are amnioates, but fish and amphibians are anamnioates. So correct answer is third. Which of the following group of animals maintains high and constant body temperature such as mammals? So living mammals, which is the other class that will maintain the body temperature and high metabolic rate, and there is no, it's a homeothermic, means it should be aves or birds. Whereas this is poikilothermic, poikilothermic and poikilothermic. But birds are homeothermic. You should know also adaptations of birds. Birds, how do they adapt? What is the flight adaptation of birds? Is they have a streamlined body. Okay, there are presence of wings for flying. And certain organs like urinary bladder, ovary will not be there. One of the ovary won't be there, and urinary bladder will be absent, because of which weight of the body reduces. And light-weighted bones, air-filled bones will be there, called pneumatic bones. And very strong flight muscles will be there, like pectoralis major. Okay, and the excretion is solid, and therefore it does not require extra water. So therefore, semi-solid excretion is there, because of which it can conserve the water. and also these all will make it light weighted, and at the same time wings also are there that will help to fly. So anything that helps a bird to fly will be a flight adaptation. So animal that undergoes inactive stage during the summer. Summer will be which one? Aestivation. Whereas winter will be hibernation. And remaining terms are not relevant to the dormant state of the. In which of the following animal post-anal tail is formed? What is post-anal tail? It is one of the diagnostic characters of chordates. I told you to keep it in mind, diagnostic characters of chordates. So earthworm is the invertebrate, lower is an invertebrate, scorpion is invertebrate, snake is what? It's a reptile, it is one of the chordates, so it should have the post-anal tail. So correct answer is fourth one. Which of the following is a flightless bird? Remember, flightless bird will prove which evolutionary theory? Lamarckism the flightless bird are as a proof for Lamarckism's postulate. They support Lamarckism. Which among them is a flightless bird? Ostrich, emu, kiwi. All of these are flightless birds. Which of the following is not a characteristic features in frog? So frog, what is there? The skin is moist and slimy. Is it correct? Not, they're asking. So this is, each of the four limbs and hind limbs have five digits is the correct answer, because the frog has four limbs. Here frog, we are taking standard as Rana tigrina. So Rana tigrina is going to have. So Rana tigrina is going to have four limbs and then hind limbs. Four limbs are good at balancing after a jump, and hind limbs are powerful, so the jumping is possible because of hind limb. And you should know that four limbs have four digits and hind limbs have five digits. But here they are telling that both four limbs and hind limbs both have five digits will be wrong. So here also, what is the correct, what they are asking question, which is not, that means this is the correct one. The hepatic portal, renal portal systems are present, though both are present in frogs, so this will not answer. Skin, buccal cavity and lungs are respiratory organ in frog, that is also true. So this is also not answer. Which is not correct is the second one. So answer is the second one. Bone with air cavities. This bone itself is a flight adaptation in birds. It's called as pneumatic bones. Pneumatic bones are light weighted bones because they are filled with air, aerated bones. So as a result, this light weightedness will increase its adaptation in the air. In flying mode, it will increase. Birds, you should know, they don't have teeth, so they are edentulous. So it is called pneumatic bone. In amphibians, no. In sesamoid bone in birds, no. Pneumatic bones in birds is correct. The third one is correct, because cancellous bone in reptile will be incorrect. So correct. Which is not correct? Humans are ureotelic. This is not an answer. Birds are uricotelic. This is also not an answer. Lizards are. Whale is ammonotelic, will be wrong. Whale is a mammal. So basically it will be ureotelic. So here lizards, uricotelic correct, because it is a reptile. So you should know which are the groups that will secrete uric acid. The three main groups are secreting uric acid will be reptiles, birds, and then insects. These three groups are going to excrete uric acid. And whereas other terrestrial forms, non-aquatic terrestrial forms, they will be excreting uric acid. So whale is among shellfish will be incorrect. So frog is able to change the color limitedly. It will not change the color like chameleon, but limited color change is possible in frog. This limited color change is due to hormones as well as nervous system. So correct answer will be both A and C. Okay. Melanocytes are just cells, but who will induce these melanocytes to produce more melanin or less melanin ultimately depends on hormones and nervous system. So correct answer is 4. Identify the group which includes animals, all of which give birth to young ones. So you have to identify the group of animals that are viviparous. All of them in this group should be viviparity should be there, or they should be viviparous. Dolphin, okay, kangaroo is not viviparous. It produces mammary fetus, incomplete fetus. Platypus is egg-laying, so it is not viviparous, an egg-laying mammal. So because of penguin, what happens is the second option is kind of, because of kiwi, okay, just a minute. Because of kiwi, the third is getting cancelled. And here, lion correct, whale correct, ostrich. Because of ostrich, the fourth is, because they are oviparous. Oviparous, oviparous, oviparous. So now, at the most, you can select is kangaroo. Remember, kangaroo does not have placenta. So it gives birth to young ones, but their young ones will be incomplete. So that incomplete fetus is called mammary fetus. But however, it will give birth to fetus, not completely developed young ones. Okay. So you can tell kangaroo is not purely giving birth directly to fully developed young ones, but it is going to give birth to incomplete fetus called mammary fetus. So near answer will be this one. Okay, the first one. Remaining all, because of oviparous animals, the remaining cannot be in. Which one is absent in frog? You should know already in the previous question, what is absent is diaphragm is absent. When diaphragm is absent, then how do the frog breathe? It will breathe by positive pressure breathing. When diaphragm is absent, diaphragm is also called phrenic muscle. And which is that nerve that innervates the phrenic muscle? That muscle is called as phrenic nerve. And therefore, what will be absent in frog is the phrenic nerve will be absent, that innervates phrenic muscles. Since frog do not have phrenic muscles, it won't be innervated. Understand? So renal portal system, it is present in frog. Both A and B will be wrong. None of these also cannot be an option. To which taxonomical group does whale belong? Taxonomical group. It is a fish? No. Reptile? No. Arthropod? No. Mammal is correct. So what it is? It is aquatic mammal. Whale is an aquatic mammal. When it comes to whale, you all should know that whale, under the skin of the whale, there is a fat called as blubber, and that blubber only makes the whale to tolerate the cold waters. Okay. That makes it to prevent the heat loss from the body, as a result, conserve the temperature. So which type of kidneys are formed in amphibians? You know that there are broadly in animals, the type of kidney will be pronephric, mesonephric, and metanephric. Out of this, which is not so well developed is the first one, which is highly developed is, so mesonephric is in between the two. So therefore, the correct And so for amphibians, we'll have a mesonephric kidney. Whereas the frog only, for example, in amphibians, we consider frog, its larva tadpole, it can have the pronephric kidney. They differ in each other in presence of structures like Bowman's capsule and the number of ducts. Okay. So metanephric kidney begins with reptiles. First time from reptile onwards to all higher structures, it will have all higher animals. What type of kidney will be there is metanephric. Amphibians have mesonephric kidney. Air bladder. Air bladder will occur in what? Bony fish or osteocytes. And labia is the best example for bony fish or osteocytes. Correct answer is labia. Scales are found in Pisces. You know that chondrichthyes have what? Like white scales. Okay, this will be present in cartilage fish. Whereas ctenoid, ganoid, and cycloid will be present in osteocytes. So therefore, correct answer, the scales, protective scales will be present in fish, whether it is chondrichthyes or osteocytes. Tadpole, tail. What is the purpose of tadpole? Tail. It is nothing but locomotory structures. Tadpole is a larva right now. Tadpole you are considering as larva of frog. Here you are. It is nothing but the larva of frog. Okay. What is the purpose of tail in the larva of frog? Will be nothing but it is a locomotory structures. So next is, which of the following is not a characteristics of snake? Snake do produce eggs. Snake do not have sternum. That is the characteristic. Sternum is a breastbone, it is called, so it's not present in snakes. So otherwise, the snakes have scales, eggs as well as kidney. What they're asking, which is not present? Not present means they don't have sternum. Nucleated RBC is present in what? So, nucleated RBC is not present in man, in rat, or rabbit, which are mammals. Nucleated RBC is present in frog. Frog is an amphibian, and amphibians have biconvex nucleated RBC. So they are asking that there is an animal that lays egg and it also secretes milk, means it should have mammary glands. So you know that the order of an animal that has the mammary glands will be what? Prototherians. Prototherians are generally a group of mammals that are egg laying. Now, example of the egg-laying mammals are duck-billed platypus. It means it lays egg, cladoid eggs like reptiles, and at the same time, like it has a typical mammary glands like that of mammals. So, based on this, this platypus can be called as connecting link between reptiles as well as mammals. There is one more connecting link between reptiles as well as mammals. It is called as spiny anteater. Okay. is also called echidna. Echidna. Okay. So spiny ant eater. So correct answer here is the third. Now among this, you have to identify the aquatic mammals, the cetaceans or aquatic mammals, the order cetacean. So here you can see Balaemnoptera whale, it is an aquatic one, Ichthys horse, then this one Delphinus, whereas Felis cat, and these all are terrestrial one. So aquatic mammals will be the first and the third. Okay. So aquatic mammals will be first and third, then which option you are selecting here? You are selecting the first one. First and third are aquatic mammals. Now here, addition of which element in water speeds up metamorphosis in frog tadpole larva? Remember, tadpole larva will convert into adult, and I told the process is called as metamorphosis. This requires a very important hormone called thyroid hormone. This hormone is there, then only tadpole can convert into adult because of this hormone. But you all know that there is one element that is essential for normal thyroid hormone production, and that is iodine. Understand? So therefore, suppose from tadpole larva, if the thyroid hormone is removed, it will never give rise to adult. It will remain as tadpole only. And in a tadpole state itself, it becomes sexually active, means that is, that phenomena will be called as neoteny. Okay. So now if you remove thyroid hormone, it cannot form an adult. Second, suppose there is a tadpole larva in the water. In the water, there is a tadpole larva is there. And from the water, you are removing iodine. What is being removed from water? Thyroid, this larva has thyroid gland. It can produce thyroid hormone also. But in this water, what is not there? Iodine is not at all there. Then the thyroid gland of this tadpole larva cannot produce thyroid hormone. So it cannot transform into adult. It cannot change into adult. In both cases, either if thyroid gland is removed, it cannot form adult. Or if water, from water, if iodine is totally removed, that time also it cannot form adult. Understand? So now what happens is, now if suppose iodine is put back, then again tadpole will form adult. The glands present in the skin of frog are what kind of glands? It can be mucus glands, and certain poisonous frogs are so poisonous glands. Both are there in frog. And what will not be there in frog is sweat, sebaceous sweat. So which will not be there is sweat. Sweat glands will not be there, and sebaceous glands will not be there, because these two characters are characteristics of mammals, and frog is not a mammal. It is amphibia, so it should have a mucus glands as well as which one? Poisonous glands also. Okay. Flightless birds among the following is what? Again, they have given flightless bird. Vulture, okay, pigeon, they're not flightless. Crow, again, struthio, that is ostrich. It is a flightless bird. Okay, so this is that. And you know that birds have in the tail region have a oil gland called as brain gland. Okay. So bone marrow is present where? Bone marrow is present in reptiles? Yes. It is present in amphibians? Yes. But it is not present in apes. But however, some birds may have small quantity of bone marrow, but that is very rare. Majority of the birds do not have the bone marrow. What is a bone marrow? Suppose in mammals, which animals? In mammals and other reptiles and amphibians, there are long bones here. At the center of long bone, there is a cavity. This cavity is called medullary cavity or bone marrow cavity. Inside this, there is a myeloid tissue. And this myeloid tissue is nothing but the bone marrow. And mammals also do have bone marrow. And you should remember that B cells will mature in bone marrow. And in apes, there is a bone marrow. No bone marrow is there. Then by the bone marrow cells, only B cells will form. In apes, there is no bone marrow. Then from where the B cells will come? It will come from a site called bursa fibrosis. Which character is found only in mammals? Okay. What is that? Mammary glands. The characteristic features of mammals. So what is the scientific name for king cobra? Naza is actually Indian cobra. Bangaras is a great viper. These are all hemotoxic snakes. These are neurotoxic. Nazahana is actually the name of king cobra. Whereas Naza is the name of Indian cobra. So correct answer is third one. The following characteristic is not common between birds and mammals. That means, what is the difference between birds and mammals? Different. Breathing using lungs. Of course, birds also breathe using lungs, and mammals also breathe using lungs. And you should know that birds, apart from lungs, they have additional air sac that is responsible for a phenomena called double circulation. Why the air sacs will be present in the bird of a lung is to increase the efficiency of breathing. So to take up more oxygen. So because oxygen is required by high metabolic rate going on in the birds. But they're asking, this is not common. This is correct. So mammals are viviparous. Birds are not viviparous. They are egg-laying. They lay the eggs that are shelled. Laying of shelled eggs are called as cladoid eggs. The shelled eggs are called as cladoid eggs. Warm-blooded. Both are warm-blooded. Okay. And ossified. Okay. There is bone. Presence of bone in both. How is male frog identified? So to identify a male and a female frog, one should know the phenomena called sexual dimorphism. So you should know which are the sexual dimorphic characters in frog. So how to differentiate a male frog and female frog? Male frog is a bit smaller, female frog is a bit larger. Male frog have vocal sacs, but female frog do not have vocal sacs. What for that purpose of vocal sac? Purpose of vocal sac is it produces a croaking sound. And third, a sexual dimorphism between a male frog and a female frog is male frog in the forelimb, in just below the digit, there is a swelling, and that is called as amplexusary pad. It is also called a copulatory pad. So answer will be the first one. A copulatory pad in the first digit of the hind limb will be wrong here. What will be wrong? Hind limb will be wrong. Okay. Hind limb will be wrong. Okay. Then female cockroach has anal circuit. No, anal style will differ. This is also will not help to identify. Let's see. Question, don't put it as how is male identified. You should put how is male identified in following animal. Then this question will be appropriate. Otherwise, the question will not go correct. So here, male shark, they have claspers. This is correct. So male shark can be. That means this question should be how is male identified in the following animals. How is male identified in cockroach? By anal style. How is male identified in frog? Because of copulatory pad present in the first digit of forelimbs. How is male shark identified? Because of presence of claspers. Now, claspers are copulatory organ in male shark. Female ascaris, there is a posterior curvature will be wrong. So all these identification is wrong. Only one identification is correct. That is the third one. So correct answer is third. So here female ascaris, there is no posterior curvature. It is very much straight like this. But male ascaris is having the typical curvature. Understand? So this is male. This will be female. Got? So correct answer will be third one. So now you see, following is a reptilian character of bird. Scales on the body. Okay. On the body. Reptilian character of the bird. Scales on the body. Entire body will be wrong. Okay. Scales may be confined to the legs. Four-chambered heart is a reptilian character? No. Two special chambers, scop and gizzard. Also, comparison is not there. Okay. Next, you see, egg with calcareous cell is correct. So, if you are considering evolutionary characters, your embryological characters are much better than morphological characters. So, you have to select the one which is embryological characters rather than going for morphological characters. So, correct answer is egg with calcareous shell. What is common between parrot, platypus, kangaroo? Parrot is a bird, it is a homeotherm, correct? Platypus and kangaroo mammal, homeotherm, correct. Toothless jaws. Platypus are, a kangaroo is not toothless because of this, the second is cancelling. Post anal tail. The chordates will have post anal tail. So these two have, so this, all the three, the character should be common for all the three. This is oviparous. Only platypus and parrot are oviparous. Kangaroo is not oviparous. So, it's, so only common feature in all the three will be homeotherm. What is homeothermy? Ability to regulate temperature. Ability to regulate temperature. This is called as homeothermy. But so it means that it can keep its body temperature, whatever may be the temperature in the surrounding, its body temperature can be kept constant. Okay, so that is what is called as homeothermy. Which of following is not a living fossil means it is not there now. It is already not dead. It is already extinct. It is not living now. So that is nothing but archaeopteryx. So whereas king crab limulus is a living fossil. Sphenodon is a living fossil. Peripatus also is a living fossil. And all of these living fossils are also what? They are also connecting links they are. Got? So they are the connecting links. Got? Which of the following is not a living fossil? Okay. Now Archaeopteryx, you should know, it has some characters of reptiles and it has some characters of birds. Since it is having the characters of both birds as well as reptiles, you can call it as connecting link. And you know that the connecting link have evolutionary significance and they established the evolutionary pathways. Asymmetry. What is asymmetry? On the basis of classification only you have studied. Which of the following can show asymmetry? Aurelia is having a radial symmetry. Hydra is having biradial symmetry or radial symmetry. Shark is having bilateral symmetry. Now the one that has irregular is nothing but the amoeba. Amoeba, if any axis is drawn in any way, there is no symmetrical halves produced at all. No symmetrical halves produced. Okay. No symmetrical halves produced. Therefore, it is called as asymmetric. It's called as asymmetric. amoeba is asymmetric, certain of the sponges are asymmetric, and rarely some will be having spherical symmetry. So therefore, the correct answer is amoeba. Now we'll look here. Freshwater bony fish maintain water balance by excreting hypotonic urine. Okay. So, drinking small excreting waste from uric acid, excreting salt. So urine of the fish will be, see here, what will be there is the fish is going to, they are telling bony fish, okay. Bony fish, now we consider that bony fish to be majorly fresh water. In fresh water, the salt concentration is less, so it is hypotonic. And here, it is hypertonic. And these will excrete salt across the gill is not important. It will try to conserve the salt. Okay. Excessive salt will develop only in the marine fish. Okay. But this is a freshwater fish. Freshwater fish, there can be loss of salt. So it conserves the salt by excreting dilute hypotonic urine. Freshwater bony fish. In freshwater bony fish, water is hypertonic? No. Water is hypotonic? Yes. Hypotonic condition inside the fish? No. Both one and also no. Correct answer is the second one. Okay. So in freshwater bony fish, the water is, how it is? The water is hypotonic. Most highly advanced character in crocodile, which is a reptilia. Advanced character means advanced reptiles are birds and mammals. So it is asking which is that advanced character. Now compared to birds and mammals, which is more advanced? Mammals are more advanced. So which mammalian character a crocodile has? It is a powerful jaws? No. Shelled egg is not the mammalian character. Thecodont teeth is a mammalian character, but not so important as compared to the fourth one, that is the mammalian character of crocodile is four chambered heart. Another mammalian character of crocodile is it has diaphragm. Some reptiles show autotomy. What is that is? What is autotomy? Shedding body parts. Shedding body parts or cutting off its own body parts during emergency. During emergency is called autotomy. Starfish has a feature of autotomy. Even the lizard has a feature of autotomy where it shed its tail under emergency. When it knows it is at risky conditions, then it is going to shed its tail. Now, autotomy is possible in case of reptiles. There. Voluntary breaking of tail to confuse the enemies. Rather than confuse, it can tell you protective in function. Signal for charging will be wrong. Signal for attraction and courtship will be wrong. State for starvation prior to death also will be wrong. So, correct answer will be voluntary breaking of the tail to confuse the enemies. Okay. So, this correct answer for the first one will be the first one. Most favorable land adaptation for reptiles. Okay. Most moist skin. Moist skin, the reptile don't have moist skin only. The first note. Scales on the body is the correct answer because reptiles are known for having scales on the body. Now, if scales are there, it can prevent loss of water from the surface of body. That means it will help to conserve the water. One of the mode in which the terrestrial animals have what the terrestrial animal property is that they conserve water, whereas those in aquatic animals, they already are in water, the conservation of water is not there. Pulmonary respiration, even amphibians do have pulmonary respiration. So in the terrestrial mode, the important one will be scale on the body. Okay, so pulmonary respiration is respiration through lungs. That is also help a terrestrial mode of life, but out of that, conservation of water is more important. Okay, pulmonary respiration can also be exhibited by amphibians, which are lower animals compared to the reptiles. Animals have innate ability to escape from attack from enemies. That is called predation. Example given below, select the incorrect ones. So, correct answer will be the third one. Here there is a camouflage and hiding from the predations. Mimicry is there, but here there is no mimicry shown in the third option. So, poison fangs are basically the self-defensive parts present in these animals. Why do mammals lack mucus glands on their skin? Because their skin is not simply an answer, but it may not be an right. Skin is tough, no. Epidermis has many layers, correct, but that is not the reason why mucus gland. Why mucus gland is not absent in mammals is mammals don't require mucus gland as mammals do not respire through skin. Yeah, correct answer. Now you see here. For a skin to respire, skin should be very thin, it should be highly vascular, and above all, what it should be? It should be moist. When all the three properties will come, then the skin has an ability to respire. Which of the following group of animals breathe through the skin? Frog, salamander, earthworm. All of them have a respiration called cutaneous respiration. What is cutaneous respiration? Respiration through skin is called as cutaneous respiration. Now in this, lizard will not cutaneously respire, so second one is incorrect. Then chameleon will not respire, the third one is incorrect. Then fish also will not have cutaneous respiration, so the fourth one also will be incorrect. So, here all of you, which pair of an animal group has, just you have to know separation, has oxygenated and deoxygenated blood separate? That means, in which of the animal there is a four-chambered heart? Remember, if the four-chambered heart is there, then it will have no mixing. There is no mixing with deoxygenated blood from oxygenated blood. So in this, among the four options, you have to select that animal that is four-chambered. It means that where the oxygenated blood will not mix with deoxygenated blood. Amphibians have three-chambered, reptiles also have three-chambered. So what will occur? There is a mixing of oxygenated blood with deoxygenated. That means they are not separated, they are mixed. In birds and mammals, this is a correct answer. Why? Birds and mammals have four-chambered heart. I told when there is a four-chambered heart, there is no mixing of oxygenated blood with deoxygenated blood. Instead of mixing, they become separated. Reptiles are three-chambered. Birds are four-chambered. So one is incorrect. So this would be the answer. Correct answer is this. Reptiles and mammals. Reptiles is three-chambered, mammals are four-chambered. Mixing occurs in reptiles, but mixing will not occur. So this also will not be an answer. So the correct answer will be the second one. Which of the following structures present correctly only in mammalian brain? Already I told that corpus callosum. Okay, so corpus callosum is a nervous tissue. It's a white nervous tissue that will help to communicate between a right hemisphere of the brain, will communicate the right hemisphere with that of left hemisphere of the brain. So therefore it will be called as what? Corpus callosum. Where it is present? Typically it is present in most of the placental mammals. Now already I told what is placental mammals called? Eutherians. It means that eutherians or placental mammals will have corpus callosum. Then can metatherian have like marsupials? No. Can duck-billed platypus like prototherians have? No. So correct answer here will be corpus callosum 4. Which of the following internal feature is characteristics of mammals? Glisson's capsule is characteristics of mammals. Apart from this, you know that bone have what? Heaversian system. Even Heaversian system is characteristics of that of mammals. Whereas vertebral column is present in other animals also. Adipose connective tissue is commonly present in animals and even pericardium. Then the structure, what is a Gleason's capsule is? It is the covering for the liver. So it's a covering for the liver is called as a Gleason's capsule, and it is typically present in mammals. And similarly also, what is there? Heaversian system. And even corpus callosum is a characteristic of mammals. So this completes the multiple choice discussion based on Animal Kingdom 2, which includes phylum Chordata.